On Friday, the 1st of November, right after Halloween. Unusual topic today. The talk about China, and I talk about them a lot, but what I'm really talking about today is the Chinese are the strangest real estate investors and market ever. And you have to understand that the Chinese, you know, the communist government really didn't own broadly real estate until recent decades. They opened that up. So this is the first time they've been able to own and profit from real estate. They've had this massive 30-some year urbanization project on steroids, fastest growing urbanization project in China in history, top down pushed by the government. So you got nouveau riche people in China that now that they've seen real estate, it's only gone up. It's the most overvalued, the most appreciated market in recent years of any, in pretty much in history and certainly in this time period. So they just think you can't go wrong buying real estate. Of course, I've been saying they're going to find out they can go very, very wrong. Now, a couple statistics just to bring you up to date. 89% of real estate is owned, not rented. It is not much of a rental market because of the lower price for renting and the small percentage that do rent. Rentals are only 2% of the entire market there. It's an owned market. Even if two or three families buy a small condo together because that's all they can afford. And of course, the people who can least afford it are these migrant workers who make the lowest wages coming in. So you've got a market, 89% owned, most overvalued in the world, in Hong Kong, the most wealthy segment of China, the single most overvalued city by far in the world, and 75% of Chinese, wealthy or not, on average, 75% of the net worth of Chinese households is in real estate compared to more like 30% in the U.S., and that's at the top of a bubble. So very unique market. Now, something's about to happen, and this is what I call the silver lining. The silver lining of a crash. Crashes are good. The reasons we have booms and busts is the busts create new possibilities, clear out dead wood, new innovations. Well, here's what's going to happen in China, and I'm just seeing it in a recent article. The Chinese, for the first time, are saying, oh my God, real estate's so expensive. And, you know, it's just this cultural taboo. You can't possibly get married if you don't own something. I mean, they literally forbid people to get married in many cases, parents and et cetera. High down payments, all this sort of stuff. But they're starting to think, well, maybe we should be renting like normal people, young people do. And there's a normal rental market for people who really can't afford expensive real estate. So they're just getting this inkling. So here's what the crash does. Now, first of all, when real estate finally starts to crash significantly, there is no way the government can stop it other than just saying nobody can sell real estate. You know, we forbid you to, because so much of the real estate is empty. 22% of homes and condos in China and 27% in some of the largest, most overbuilt cities are vacant. So a lot of these people own real estate and a lot of them are second or third houses because everybody speculates when they can in China because of the, you know, because their nouveau riche is the greatest real estate market ever. So who are you going to sell to when people finally realize, oh, it's not okay to have a super overpriced empty condo, which nobody would think of here. Overpriced, number one, but empty, my God, what are you, an idiot? Well, that's how new they are to real estate. So all of a sudden, who are you gonna sell to? When they start to panic and say, well, gosh, I better sell this second house, or younger people, gosh, I can't even afford this house anymore, you know. Who are you gonna sell to in an 89% owned market? Now, you know, there may be, as happened in the United States in 2008-09, you know, hedge funds or private equity or maybe the government steps in and starts buying houses and then turning around renting affordable housing. But overall, this is what's gonna be forced. People are gonna start to realize housing's overpriced and it's gonna fall more rapidly than any market in history. 50 to 80%, I'm saying that. I mean, that's just massive for real estate. We only had 34% in the 2008 Great Recession crash in the US, only 26% in the Great Depression. So that's massive. Who are they going to sell to? The answer is nobody. There's going to be nobody to buy this stuff. So what's going to happen? People are going to have to start renting it out. And there's plenty of empty real estate, and there's still migrant workers that can't afford this stuff and young people. So everybody from now on, there's probably going to be a sudden shift. So renting is in, and renting is going to be affordable and the smart thing to do for young couples and migrants moving from rural to urban areas, instead of having to buy for self-respect and to get married and to get laid if you're a man or whatever. So this is what I, again, what I call the silver lining. This is something that's way out of balance, and the bubble is keeping it out of balance. Why would somebody not keep that empty condo when it keeps going up? Why would not somebody, when Chinese save so much, and even though they have to make down payments, that's their advantage. Why wouldn't they buy that second home? And that's the quickest way to make wealth. And it is for the everyday person, not just wealthy people, for the everyday person in China. When the bubble collapses, people see reality and they do the right thing. So that's the silver lining of a downturn or bubble crash. Things go back to reality, economy rebalances, Chinese, especially younger people entering the job market and people moving from rural to urban areas. And they still, at 60% urban, the fastest to get there in history in mass, still have another 20-25% of their population, which is hundreds of millions of people, that still are going to move into cities. These people will now be able to rent at a much more affordable price and have a much better standard of living coming into the job market. So again, good things come out of bad, and as I've been saying, there's no two ways about it. I don't care how much the government controlled it to get there. The more you overbuild, overinvest, build a bubble, just like happened in Dubai. When I was there in 2006, I was saying, oh man, you guys got the biggest bubble and the most cranes back then. Everybody said, no, the government controls it. The government will buy if nobody else. The next year, 40% crash. You can't control it past the point. China is going to have the biggest bubble burst in real estate, and it's going to be a big benefit for the up-and-coming rural to urban migrants and the young people in China. It's going to be a huge, massive hit to the net worth of older people who own all this real estate, rich and everyday people, because everybody bought into the bubble almost in China.